What's up guys, welcome back to a new video. In today's video we're gonna talk about something that I actually mentioned in a video a couple weeks back.
I'm definitely gonna warm up properly because I have a bit of an issue with my right shoulder. However, I'm probably gonna make like a full video dedicated to that whole topic in the future, probably next week, to kind of give you guys a bit more details and insights on that.
Yeah, it isn't actually the next week now, it's actually about 2 weeks in the future, but I have a very good reason why I'm actually making the video now, because I actually didn't really want to make this video until like the whole injury kind of thing was actually fully done. Right now it is about 2 weeks in the future and I am completely pain free in my shoulder, and today I'm pretty much going to show you guys or share with you guys the things that I actually did to get my shoulder from feeling horrendous to feeling strong. So let's go right into the few things that I want to talk about. So first of all, some backstory on basically how this whole injury thing basically started. So basically a couple of weeks ago, I did a push workout where I actually achieved the advanced tuck for the first time in my life. And I remember thinking like after that workout, like I felt some irritation in my shoulder. But like when you're training, like you have pains and aches all the time. Like I actually didn't really link it to any kind of beginning injury, but like when I actually like went to sleep that night, I remember my shoulder just feeling horrendous. Like I don't know what it was, like something in the front of my shoulder, like probably some tendon, felt like just not really good. And like I remember literally like not being able to sleep because of the pain. And I was like, and like I remember thinking like, really, this is the start of 2021 and I'm gonna start this year off with a shoulder injury. Nice. And over the next coming days, like especially like through training, like it definitely got like progressively worse. I was like, really? I mean, at that point I was really thinking like, all right, like I have a shoulder injury, like I'm gonna be out for a couple of weeks, or I have to change a couple of things up for the next coming weeks. And I was like, great. First thing that happens in 2021 is a shoulder injury. So I kind of felt like a bit bad about it. However, like after that, I pretty much like got to work. I was like, all right, it's not an injury at this point in time, because like I actually wasn't feeling it like throughout the day, like only after training. So I was like, well, there may actually be a couple of things that I can do in order for me to kind of like evade the shoulder injury and yeah, not get injured, just kind of keep it to some aches and some pains. And that is exactly what I did. So the first thing I actually did when I noticed my shoulder aching a bit is basically boosting my rest and my recovery. So what I basically did for like a couple of weeks, basically is doing like deload weeks. So like, I mean, I've actually made a video on this topic like a couple of months ago. Basically a deload basically means just kind of drastically decreasing your training volume to increase your rest and your recovery. And basically like for a couple of weeks time, I pretty much like halved my training volume for a couple of weeks. This can actually make a big difference, because like I've had this like multiple times in the past where like I actually feel like something aching and something hurting, and like just doing like a week of like less training volume can usually fix it. Like it's kind of a really crazy thing. Just like a week of like training less can actually fix it pretty much. So like and that's actually the first thing that I actually did, expecting it to go the same way as like previous things. But like obviously while deload wasn't enough. So yeah, I actually ended up deloading for like, I don't know, like I think about like 2 to 4 weeks, just like literally pulling my volume right down, really just trying to like not like put too much pressure on it, to be honest. However, like I was going pretty hard in my workouts, but like I was giving my body sufficient time to recover from them, therefore not making the injury any worse than it actually already was. Then the second thing that I actually did was actually finding the weak link within my body. So usually when you have some sort of an injury, some sort of a pain or an ache, it's usually down to something not being right. Like it's usually down to like something being a bit weaker, like some weak link inside your body that is basically causing you to have that pain or that injury. So for all the people with absolutely no backstory on my current history, I actually did like 1 year of kids therapy at uni. And even though I actually failed that year completely, there are definitely a couple of things that I still know from doing that 1 year. And I pretty much just did it all myself. So basically what I did is pretty much just like trying to find the weak link within the shoulder. And what turned out is like when I did an external rotation in my shoulder, like right up to about here, my shoulder couldn't handle it. So basically like my shoulder wasn't a big fan of being in that position. It basically meant that like my external rotators were definitely weakened. And like I definitely get it, because like At this point in time, I'm absolutely hammering my chest, I'm actually hammering my lats, and they're both are muscles that basically do the internal rotation of the shoulder. So basically my internal rotation was getting quite a lot stronger than my external rotation, leading me to have an injury. So that was definitely like a big eye opener to me, just like really finding something that actually was not really right. Therefore, I can basically do what I needed to do, which is fix the weak link, therefore fix the injury. So basically from that point on, I just did a ridiculous amount of face pulls. I'm literally just doing this motion all the time while I was training, using a resistance band, something that I actually showed in one of my previous videos. But yeah, just kind of bringing up the weak link and therefore pretty much like fixing the injury itself. The third thing that I did was doing a complete form check over all my exercises. So basically, whenever you have an injury, it's usually down to something not being right, like within your training. So like I obviously knew that like my external rotation was a bit weaker on my right side. However, like I definitely wanted to still check like whether or not I was actually doing anything wrong with my form or my exercise. And it actually turned out to like when I was doing like pectoral planche push-ups, my right shoulder, my left shoulder was actually like very stable, like in the socket. My right shoulder was actually creeping forward quite a lot. It pretty much being in like a very protracted position, which you need to some extent in the pectoral planche push-ups. However, doing too much of it definitely can cause injury. So basically, like that was again a big eye opener for me. Pretty much like realizing, all right, I'm doing something wrong there. Let's fix it. And I definitely feel like I'm getting like quite a lot stronger now on like my pectoral planche push-ups just by fixing the form on that one exercise. So if you have an injury, definitely do a form check on your exercise, because actually the cause of the injury might lie in your training itself. The fourth thing is actually prioritizing my warm-up. So basically, like, I mean, I actually wanted to do a video on this for like quite a while to like show you guys my warm-up routine. Basically, I warm up for like 5 to 10 minutes before every single workout. So I basically warm up like pretty properly already, but like definitely like when I had this injury, like I definitely prioritized my warm up even more, because you don't want to start training like until you're like loose and like warmed up basically. So like I would not start a workout without being proper loose, properly like, you know, warmed up, because like that can literally mean the difference between making an injury worse or better. So basically, prioritize warm-up, make sure that everything is nice and loose before starting your workouts. And then the fifth and final thing is doing more flexibility and mobility work. Now the research on this is actually quite controversial, because there actually is no like definitive like research that actually shows you that like doing flexibility and mobility work is actually going to prevent injuries. However, like I mean, basically like there are certain people that say that it will prevent injuries, the other part of it basically says that it doesn't. So basically, I actually ended up doing it anyway, mainly because like the way that I look at it is like when you stretch out your shoulder, you obviously like force blood into the muscle, and injuries will usually heal quite a lot quicker if actually like promotes blood flow towards like that part of your body. So a couple of videos ago, I definitely said that I was lacking on my flexibility and my mobility work. However, like I definitely brought that one back up, and I feel like it definitely like helped me to an extent, because like again, I could really like stretch my shoulder out, just kind of get more blood flow to it, therefore getting more blood flow into the muscle, therefore increasing the speed of recovery. All right guys, so those pretty much were the five things that I actually ended up doing to evade my shoulder injury. And as I said in the beginning of the video, I'm currently training completely pain free. I have no pain in my shoulder anymore, so pretty much it worked. So yeah, yeah, pretty happy with it, to be honest. Definitely gonna take this on in the future. Definitely like a couple of things that I'm gonna keep doing from now on. So I'm pretty much just gonna start implementing more face pulls, more mobility and more flexibility with my training routine, to be much like not fix injuries, but like just kind of prepare for them in the future. And it goes to show you that pretty much no one is perfect. Everybody deals with injuries from time to time. It's just a matter of how you deal with them and how you fix them. So basically, guys, that was the whole video. If you guys have any more topics that you want me to cover on future videos, let me know in the comment section down below. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to like and subscribe. If you guys have any more video tips to improve your content, again, the comment section is down below. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Get ready for the standard outro. See you guys next time. Laters.